Hello students, so this is the fourth part of our college website which we are building, and this part we are going to build about us section, that is the footer section and the about us page. Okay, and we are going to add the social media icons like this, which I have already added here, and this the sticky social media icons which we are going to add in this video. So let's get started. So for that, let's check our website which we are building. So this is the website which we have building. Okay, so we have built till here. I will delete this because I have not yet start building about us page, right? So I will delete it, and I need to build the section here. About a section here. So for that, I will open my Visual Studio Code. In my Visual Studio Code, I will open my website folder, open folder, and I will open the folder which I am working on it. That's on desktop. So I will open that folder, Rafael website, and I will select that folder. So here you can see it's visible everything. So I will open my index.html and CSS, both the file I will open. I will close this, and now I will come to my index.html file, and I will make here section after call to action section. I need to add one section, that is footer section I will be writing, or you can add about us. So I will write about us section, and I will control KU. I will comment it starts here, and I will be adding the ending comment, that is about us ends here. I will comment it out, control KU, and between this I will start building my website. Okay, so firstly I need to take one section, and in this section I need to assign the class. Isko main koi bhi naam de sakta hu, but I will take footer. You can give your name or you, but you need to give a proper name, right? Class name footer. So in footer, what I will do is I will be giving one h2 in footer, a section I have created, and in h2 I will write here h2, that is heading, and I will write about us, because let's open our website. Here you can see it's h2, and there is one paragraph and the social media icon and the footer part. So first I need to add h2 and then a paragraph and a social media icons. So I will add h2. After that I will add paragraph, because there is a paragraph here. So I will simply copy this paragraph, or else you can just go to the college website, and as I told you, you can copy from there. Okay. So net is not connected, so you can go to the college website and you can copy about us part whichever you like. Okay, so I will copy this little bit of part and I will paste it here between this paragraph. Okay, so let's open our live server and check how it's looking. I will open my live server here. So it's looking good. You can see it's in the middle and it's looking good. Okay, so now what I will do is I will give properties to it. Okay, so I will come to my CSS and I will add one comment here, footer section. Yeah, you can write about us section, about us section, control KU, control KU. Okay, so this is our about us section, and now I will start giving properties to about us section. And which class we have taken, that is footer footer class. So I will give properties to footer class. So I will write here footer, and in footer I will set width. What is the width? That is 100% width. So here you can see width. What is width? I will explain you. So this is the width, this is width, and this is height. So take 100% width of footer. Text alignment, I will be setting it to center. Text alignment center. Now I will be providing padding to it. I need a padding on top, or I will provide padding on top and bottom padding. So I will provide 0, 0, 3 pixel and 30 pixel and 0 pixel. So let's check how it's looking. Okay, so you can see that there is a 30 pixel of padding above and 0 below. Okay, so now I want to work on H2. I want to work on this H2. Okay, so I will call footer H2 and footer H2, and I will set its margin bottom, that is 25, margin top, that is 20 pixel, 25 pixel, and I will be setting a font weight. Making it little bit of bold, 600. You can set it 600. Let's save it. Let's check. Okay, so it's looking really perfect now. Let's view it in Chrome, because it's look beautiful in Chrome. Okay, so this is set. Now I need to add this social media icon. Okay, so for that I will open my Chrome browser. Okay, so you can open your Chrome browser, or else you can use any other browser you want, but I will get back to my Chrome and I will open my Chrome and I will write here. What I'm going to write is I want the icon, so I will write W3 school social media icons, social media icon. I will search W3 school social media icons, and I will open the first tab, how to create a social media icons. Okay, so here you can see there are varieties of social media icons here, circular and square, but I will use the square one. So what you need to do is, for using these icons in your website, you need to copy this link. This link, I will copy this, Control C, and I will paste it in index.html, in the index.html, and where I will paste it in header. In head file, in head section, I will paste it. After this, you can paste it anywhere, but please see to it that you don't paste it between these tags. So after this ending tag, you can paste it anywhere. Okay, so this I have pasted, and now I will again get back to my Chrome where I have opened this, and I need to take this font style icon, and I need to paste this in my, I want to show this below the paragraph, right? I want to show this after this paragraph, this icons. Here you can see I have pasted icons after the paragraph. So I will simply paste this Facebook and Twitter in my index, and I will paste this after this paragraph tag, and I will enter. Okay, I will save this, and now let's check. Here you can see there are two icons visible, but it's looking small, right? It's looking small. So what I will do is I will come back to my Chrome browser again, and I will paste this CSS property. This CSS property, I will paste this CSS property full heel and paste this Control C, where I will paste this in my style.css. Before I paste this, I will comment it out, social media icons icons, control KU, and I will paste here. Okay. So it was already a comment added, but I have again commented. Now let's check it how our website looks. Okay, so it's looking good. Facebook, Twitter is already there, but I need to add Instagram and LinkedIn or Gmail. You can add any, but I will add Instagram and LinkedIn. So what I will do is I will come back to my index.html. I will copy this, control C, control V, and I will write here instead of Twitter, I will write Instagram. Okay, I will write Instagram, and I will again copy and paste it, and I will write here LinkedIn. Okay, LinkedIn, Instagram and LinkedIn. Now let's check how our website looks. So here you can see this two is looking good, but I need to provide properties to this Instagram and LinkedIn, the background color, right? So what I will do is I will come back to my CSS and I will copy this Facebook and Twitter property. I will copy this Facebook and Twitter property, control C, I will paste it here, and one I will make Instagram, and here I will provide the same name which I have provided here. You can see Instagram, I will copy this, or you can provide the same name here which you have provided in index file. And I will use color orange for Instagram. Let's use orange or pink. Let's use pink color, not this pink, any other dark pink. Let's use purple. Let's use purple. Okay, now let's check. Okay, so it's purple now. Now I will give again property for LinkedIn. So I will write here LinkedIn, and I will again come back to my index.html page, and I will copy this LinkedIn here, and I will paste it in my class. I will provide property to this, and I will be using some different color. Let's use this pink for LinkedIn. Okay, now save it. Let's come back. Okay, here you can see it's looking perfect now, right? It's looking perfect. So now I will change little bit of padding, font size is looking bigger, right? I will make it little bit of small. So if I want to change the size of this font which we have used this icon, so what I will do is I will change the font size here, and I will be writing here it's 30 pixel, right? It's 30 pixels. So I will be making it as 25 pixel, little bit of small, we will make it 25 pixel. Let's check how it's looking now. Okay, so now it's little bit small and it's looking good. Okay, so now our this is ready. Social media icons we have placed here. Now how to link it? Okay, if I want to link this icon with our college website, so what I will do is I will open Rafael BBA BCA dot in our website which is already open. Sorry, I will click and I will copy this facebook.com. I will copy this full and I will try to call it. So instead of hash, I will remove this and I will place this Facebook, and let's save it and let's open. Okay, so it's working. College Facebook account is open, right? You can see the college Facebook account is open. Likewise, you can paste any link here. You can paste the link of the Twitter account. We have the Twitter account. I will go back to our college website and I will use Instagram, not Twitter. I will open this and I will copy this link, and I will get back to my index file and I will paste this and I will save this, and let's check out. I will again go back and I will click on Instagram. It's not working. I guess proper link you need to place it, so you can check it later on, right? So you have learned how to place the link here. You need to just copy and paste it here. Okay, where you need to copy and paste it, you need to paste it instead of hash sign, you need to paste this link. Okay, I need to remove this. Now check it's working or not. So now it's working. You can see the link is working, right? So you can place any other link. Now what I need to do is, okay, sorry, I will close this Facebook. And okay, now I need to write my name here. By made with kisne bana itna mehnat kiya to naam to likhna padega. You are making, so you need to add your name. So what I will do is I will get back to my index.html index.html, and I will write here, I will take one div here, or I will take one paragraph. Or else what we will do is I will take anchor tag. In anchor tag I will write here made by Parth Patel, or you can add made by Love with Parth Patel. So what you need to do is I will go back to my W3 school. I will write W3 school heart icon likhunga. W3 school heart icon, and I want this red heart. So I will copy this red heart pool. I will copy this red heart. If you want black, you can copy black, but I will copy this red and I will paste it here. Let's check how it's looking. Okay, it's not visible yet. I need to. Okay, you can see made by Love with Parth Patel. Okay, but मेरे को ऐसा बना के कोई क्लिक करे ना पार्थ पटेल पे अपने नाम पे तो मेरा फेसबुक खुल जाए, या मेरा कोई वेबसाइट हो वो खुल जाए. तो मुझे, मैंने इसीलिए लिंक इधर लिया है, तो मेरा कोई फेसबुक का आईडी रहेगा. तो इफ आई हैव माय फेसबुक अकाउंट, आई विल कॉपी दिस फेसबुक अकाउंट. इफ यू वांट टू कॉपी, यू कैन कॉपी दिस योर लिंक. यू कैन गो बैक टू योर फेसबुक एंड कॉपी दिस, एंड आई विल गेट बैक टू माई link here, and I will paste this link here. And now I will open my website, I will refresh it, I will click on my name. So here you can see my Facebook account is opening whenever someone click on my link. Okay, so it's now working, right? So now we need to add another thing, is this social media sticky bar of social media. So I will again go to W3 school. I will close this, and I need to add the sticky icons. Okay, so I will write here W3 school sticky social media icon. I will write sticky social media icons. I'll copy this out. I want this types of sticky social media icon. So what I will do is, first of all, I will copy this, because we have already copied the link of Font Awesome. We are already using in our project. So I will just copy this. Okay, social media, and I will paste this in my index. Below this, you can write here, or you can add anywhere, wherever you want. Social media, okay, icons. So this been added here. YouTube, LinkedIn, Google. Okay, so I will get back to my W3 school and I will copy this whole part, whole CSS folder. I will copy this. First I have copied this and pasted in index. Now I have copied this CSS and I will paste in CSS file. In CSS file below this, after link, we'll copy this here. Now let's check how our website is looking. Okay, here you can see, right? Here you can see it's looking great, right? Okay, it's looking great now. So now sticky social media icon is also working, and you can make it little bit smaller if you want to make smaller font. I will be using as 10 pixel. I want a small social media icons. and width I'll be using social media icons. If you want style of center padding, I will be getting as 10 pixel. Let's see, and white 10 pixel. So it's small now. Okay, you can also make little bit small. Again I will be using 8 pixel. Okay, so it's getting smaller, so it's clear now. And we can also add link to it. Okay, we can also add link like we have added earlier. So for adding the link to it, we need to paste it here for Facebook. Okay, for Facebook you need to use this Facebook. Instead of has, you need to use Twitter, Google link here, LinkedIn, YouTube link here. Okay, so I will add one YouTube link, that is Rafael BCA. Let's add of Rafael BCA. Rafael BCA. Copy this link of Rafael BCA. I will paste instead of has. I will remove this has. I will paste this link here and I will save it and I will come back to my browser. I will come back to my browser and I will refresh it. I will click and here you can see it's working properly. I have pasted the Rafael BCA link here. So this is end of our home page. We have fully created our home page. Okay, so this is the page we have created. I like viewing it in Chrome. So you can see this is the page we have created. You can give less padding and make this smaller. It's okay. You can give less padding and make this smaller, right? Okay, it's looking good now. Okay, so now what we need to do is, now we need to make about us page. So whenever I click, now it's showing nothing, right? So whenever I click on course, so it will open course page. When I click on about, it will open about us page. So I will get back to my index.html and I will add this. What I will do is I will simply copy this out. I will select all, I will copy this page and I will make one page here. File, I will take one file and write it as about dot html. Okay, so this page is ready and I will paste it. I will paste this here. So I don't need the things which I know don't need. I will remove this. Okay, I will remove the header. I will keep this text box and all. Text box I will keep. I need this navigation bar in every page, so I will keep this header section, but I will remove this text file and all. Remove this text, courses also I will remove. Our campus section I will remove. I will remove everything. I will remove image, user, icons, star icons, testimonials, call for action, but I will keep this footer section. I will keep this footer section. I removed everything. I have only kept footer section and this links. Now let's see how about us page is looking. Our about page is looking. I will open live server. Okay, so it's looking nice, but I need to pull it down. So whichever content I will be adding, it will be going downwards, right? Okay, so I will get back to my about.html. I will close index.html page for now and I will be working on about.html page. So after this I will change the class name. I will change the class name, right? I will change the class name and I will give it class name as subheader class. Subheader class I will be using in all the pages, this subheader class. Okay, I have given this class subheader class and I will be giving heading to it. After this nav completes, this nav bar, I will enter here and I will write here about us control KU, and I will give here one H1, and in H1 I will write about us, okay. And below that, after about us, I will set one section. So in this section, I don't have a closing tag. I have not copied a closing tag. First of all, I will close this section here. After about, I will close this section here. So section is already closed. So in, I will remove this comment here from here, and I will write here. Okay. So now it's perfect. After about us, I have started another section. Okay. So now let's see how it's looking. About us page. Okay, here you can see about us, and I will also remove this about us, right? I need to remove this. It's not looking good. Two about us is not looking good. So I will remove this section. Just remove this paragraph. Remove this paragraph. Let's check now. Okay, so here you can see, but it's not looking good again. I will just control and Z it now. For now, I will just control Z. I will keep it as it is. Okay. Otherwise, I need to. Otherwise, I have to again set the properties for it. Okay. So in this about, I will take one section. In this section, I will give name as class as about. call, okay. And in about call, I will take h1 via best in WAPI, via best in WAPI, and I will be adding one paragraph. I will add the same paragraph. You can go to our college website and you can add the same paragraph. Okay, I will be adding this paragraph. You can add from our college website, as I told you earlier. I will be adding the same paragraph here. Okay, so this is ready. Our paragraph is ready. Now, after our paragraph, I will add one button. So, I will just enter, and after our paragraph, I want one hero button. So we are already using hero button. So ankle, I will be assigned this as class is equals to hero button, which we have already created. And in hero button, I will write here explore now. Okay. So this is ready now, right? Now let's check how it's looking. Okay, it's looking good now, but I need to provide CSS property for this now. So what I will do, I will get back to my CSS now. I will get back to my CSS. Or I will just give properties to it, but it's not looking good. I mean, I need to provide division tag in between. Okay, it's not looking good. So I need to provide a division tag in between. So I will remove all this. Control X. I will write Control X. And in about call, I will make one class row, division row. And in division row, I will make another class, that is about call, to make that perfect. And in about call, I will paste this what we have removed. I will paste this, okay, hero button and all. I will paste this, and hero button is not looking perfect. So in about call, I will, let's check out how it's looking now. Okay, so it's looking perfect now, and hero button is looking here. It's here now. I need to work on this. I need to set it. So I will get back to my CSS, style.css, and here I will write here comment out about us page, control KU, and I will start working for it about us page. Now firstly I will call the class, that is subheader class I will call. Subheader class, you can see here we have already assigned subheader class. I will call that class and I will be setting its height, that is 50 vh, and width I will be setting it as 100% width, and background image I need to set. So I will copy which I have already set in, I will copy this full part which I have already set in a header. So I will copy this, but see to it that you have not made a mistake in a header. Okay, so let's check how it's looking now. Okay, so it's looking perfect now, but this text is here and this text is not looking perfect. Okay, and this is also looking perfect, and I need to change the image for about us. I will keep any other image, so I will remove this image, right, about us, and here you can see, yes, this is looking perfect. Okay, the image is looking perfect now. Subheading is done. I need to set a color white for this about us and all. For this I need to set a color white. So now we need to work on our header, like here and this part, and we need to place one image beside it. So now let's get back to our about us page, and here we need to place this in center. So I will again get back and I will give here, I will call for subheader, and in subheader I will call for h1. In h1 I will set margin top, that is I will provide 100 pixel, and I will provide padding left 10%. Let's check how it's looking. Okay, so it's looking good here. We can also bring it in center. Okay, but it's okay if we keep it here. And I need to change the color of it. Check color, we'll keep it white. Okay, so it's white, right? Now I will get back to my index.about.html file, and I need to check here for about called row and about call. So I need to change this name. There are two classes, so I will write about us here. Okay, so first I will need to work on about us. I will get back here in CSS and I will call class about us class. I will call about us class